What is going on, everybody, and welcome to part 7 of our machine learning with Python tutorial series. In this video, we're going to be beginning to break down linear regression and begin to build it back up in pure Python code from scratch ourselves. Before we get started, we have to kind of break down linear regression theoretically before we actually know what to program. By the time we're done here, you'll start to at least understand, one, how linear regression can be threaded, but also, most importantly, why it works with what's known as continuous data. This isn't just a happenstance. It is just fundamental to how this linear regression actually works. So let's go ahead and cover a couple examples. So let's say you've got a data set, expert visualization by syntax, like this. Okay, so when you look at these data points, do you see any sort of correlation? Well, probably, you know, you see a line that goes something like that. Okay, and let's consider another data set. And this data set will do something like this. Not the most professional dots, but you get the point, right? So you could see how you might draw a line through this. Right? No problem. And in theory, this should be a straight line. Okay. But then, what about a data set that looked like, maybe a data set that looks like this? Ignoring this ugly plot over here. Right. This data set, does it have a best fit line? Yes. Does it have correlation? Not, I mean, it probably has some sort of correlation. If anything, it looks like it has a slight negative correlation. But for the most part, I mean, you could draw a best fit line, but would it be a good fit line? Right? And the answer, of course, is no. Okay? So we can see right away that, you know, is there a relationship between, in our case, X and Y? And it doesn't look like there is a valid relationship between them. So in the case where you don't have a relationship between X and Y, doing something like linear regression is not going to be very beneficial. And also, it's just clearly that, like, yes, X could be in theory kind of continuous and Y could be continuous data, but we just see there's really no relationship here. Okay, so this data just would not work with linear regression. So let's say, though, you've got a graph, and you've got some data, okay? So we've got some data, and you decide, yeah, you sure can do linear regression, like eyeballing it or something. We might say that, okay? So we have this line, right? This pink line. This is our best fit line, right? And it is. We'll assume it's a straight line. What is the definition? Like, how do you define that line? Well, we'll take a journey back to middle school, where we remember that y equals mx plus b, right? And obviously where, you know, you got your little values next to each other, that they're being multiplied. So we know that the equation of a line is y equals mx plus b. So at any point along x, right? Like, let's say you've got some x. At any point along x, you would just, you just plug x into here, and then you need the values of m and b, and then you will just get the answer for whatever y is. Okay? So with the question of y equals mx plus b, we know that we'll be able to figure out whatever x is. But we are left trying to figure out what is M and what is B. So first let's talk about what M is. So we know M is the slope, right? So that's the slope of the line. And we know that B is the y-intercept, okay? So first let's consider the slope. So here we're gonna just address M, which is our slope. So the equation for M is for a best fit. We're talking about just for a best fit line here. The way that you figure that out is M equals, and this is going to be the mean of X times the mean of Y So when you have a straight line, those are supposed to be straight lines. When you have a straight line over the value, that's just the mean. So x, the mean of all the x's times the mean of all the y's minus the mean of all the x's times the y's. Okay, so it's important to understand the difference between this first multiplication and that second multiplication. Then it's all of that over the mean of your x's squared minus the mean of your x's squared, right? So this is the mean of all your x's to the power of 2 minus the mean of x's to the power of 2, right? And that's all of your x's. Now we're going to be talking about the y-intercept, or the best fit y-intercept. So that's just b, and that is your y-intercept. I'm just going to say y-int. And this one is actually a much easier equation, and that is actually just simply b equals, and this is going to be the mean of the y's, minus m times the mean of the x's, right? So that m is, you know, from over there. So that's how you calculate the m and the b. So again, the line is simply y equals mx plus b. We have our m here. We've got our b here. So now you're ready to go with the calculation of the best fit line given any x's and y's. Now again, this is simply on, you know, two-dimensional data. As you increase in your dimensions in vector space, this can get much more complex. But yes, whereas this is just a very simple regression example. So anyways, that's the math that goes behind it. It just basically boils down to, you know, this is the major algorithm that you're using, and to find the values, you're using this algorithm and this algorithm, and that can be very simply translated to Python code. So that's what we're going to be starting to do in the next tutorial, is converting these to actually Python code, and then applying it to some actual data here. So if you have any questions, comments, concerns, whatever, leave them below. Otherwise, as always, thanks for watching, thanks for all the support and subscriptions, and until next time.